Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I'm going to talk about how to integrate and find out the derivative of signals in Simulink. So let's get on with it. Let's start a Simulink model, and from Simulink library under continuous you can access these two blocks. Now integration and derivative of signals are both important parts used in many engineering and scientific applications. Let's perform an integration of a square wave, and we'll differentiate the integrated square wave, and we should get the square wave again. To observe the output we need a scope. I'll change the axis of the scope to 3 so that we can view all the waveforms at the same time. Along with that, I'll change the configuration parameters. This will take a moment. Let's connect our blocks. And let's see the output. This is the square wave, the integrated wave, and the differentiated wave of the triangular wave. These are the output. Now, integration and derivative of signals, as I said before, has many applications. For example, designing a model which has an application pertaining to DSP signal processing or controls or communications or anything. Talking about communication, modulation is the most fundamental part of any sort of communication. What is modulation? Now, modulation is a process of changing the properties of a periodic wave, that is the carrier wave, according to the modulating signal which contains the message. Let's try implementing an AM modulator using all the things that we've learned till now. We'll need two sine waves, as you can see in the equation above. There is one message signal which has the frequency of, let's keep it 1, and there's this carrier signal which has a frequency of, let's say, 100. Oh, 100 will be too much. Let's keep it 3. Okay, now we need to add 1 to the message signal, and to add 1 we need an adder. And we need to multiply these two signals. Find out the product block and multiply these signals. And finally, to observe the waveform, as always, we need a scope. Let's simulate and observe. This is the analog modulation. Now, similarly, to perform a frequency modulation, I have already prepared a model, because obviously this model will take a lot of time to build. This is the part of the message signal which is integrated. As you can see in the equation, the modulating signal is multiplied, is integrated first and then is multiplied by 2 pi into ft, which is the constant right here. So it is multiplied. Then it is added with another parameter, which is a combination of 2 pi into fc into t. Now t, since it is an increasing function, I've used a ramp block to build to specify t. And then again, the addition of these two goes to the trigonometric cos function, which is multiplied by the amplitude of the carrier frequency, and the final output is observed in this model. And this won't be a perfect FM modulation, but will almost represent an FM modulation. Now let's observe. See, there is a difference in wave and the frequency increases, and again it decreases. So this is FM modulation performed in Simulink. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and for further help, you can visit www.matlabhelper.com. Thank you.